Good afternoon, and welcome back to Performance of St. Paul's at St. Paul's Episcopal Church here in Key West, Florida. This is now our seventh week in our journey discovering music of psalms, hymns, and folk tunes found in the repertoire of religious music for the organ. Last week, we focused on folk tunes set with religious texts and arrangements written for the organ. I'm not quite willing to give that up yet, so I still have a few for you today. Today, we'll be offering you another version of Brother James' Air with the text from the 23rd Psalm. This setting is by Dale Wood. He lived from 1900 to 1975, and as he said, his greatest calling was to be a parish organist. So many organists agree. He also had a great gift as a composer and a teacher. Here is his setting, Brother James' Air. Setting of that famous Shaker melody, Lord of the Dance. This arrangement is by Douglas Wagner. Douglas Wagner was born in 1952 and is a native of Chicago, Illinois, and is an internationally recognized composer and arranger. As a retired public school music educator for over 30 years, Mr. Wagner now devotes his time as an ASCAP award-winning composer. He is the executive editor of the Heritage Music Press Choral Catalog and has served several denominations as a church musician. A prolific composer with over 2,400 titles of his music published, which includes original works and arrangements for choir, both church and school, concert band, orchestra, handbell ensembles, organ, piano, instrumental, solo and voice. Here is Lord of the Dance by Douglas Wagner. another setting of Come Thou Fount of Every Blessing. The hymn tune is Nettleton. The tune has been attributed to Asael Nettleton, 1783 to 1844, a well-known evangelist of the early 19th century, who was very influential with regards to the Second Great Awakening. The number of people converted to Christianity as a result of his ministry was estimated by one biographer at over 30,000 people. The Second Great Awakening was a Protestant religious revival during the 19th century in the United States. The revival spread religion through tent meetings and other rallies, emotional preaching, which sparked a number of reform movements. The Methodist and Baptist denominations grew exponentially during this time. This is a beautiful setting by Kevin Sadowski. Mr. Sadowski lived from 1955 to 2003. He was a member of Luther Memorial Church in Erie, Pennsylvania for over 30 years, where he served as cantor and organist for 24 of those years, as well as the church's learning center. Nettleton by Kevin Sadowski. In this setting, Mr. Sadowski reflected on the text of God, We Praise You, text by Christopher Idle, born in Kent, England in 1938. The paraphrasing reads, God, we praise you. God, we bless you. God, we name you, Sovereign Lord, mighty King, whom angels worship, Father, by your church adored. All creation shows your glory, heaven and earth draw near your throne, singing, Holy, 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 Lord of hosts and God alone. Christ, at God's right hand victorious, you will judge the world you made. Lord, in mercy help your servants, for whose freedom you have paid. Raise us from the dust of glory. Guard us from all sin today. King enthroned above all praises, save your people, God, we pray. Part ways from the folk tune now. Let us put ourselves back on the other side of the pond. What was happening in the Anglican Church at the beginning of the 20th century? Let us first have a visit with Herbert Howells. Mr. Howells was born in 1892 in Gloucester, England, the youngest of six children. His father was to declare bankruptcy when Herbert was just 12 years old. Thankfully for Herbert, a young nobleman by the name of Charles Bathurst took a liking to the boy and saw his considerable talent and paid for the young Herbert's private lessons and early schooling in music. In 1912, Howells moved to London to study at the Royal College of Music, where his teachers included Charles Villiers Stanford, Hubert Parry, and Charles Wood. Very early on at university, he took an interest in composition and wrote a mass, a piano concerto, several orchestral pieces, and his first set of psalm settings for organ. Howells' promise seemed to be cut short in 1915 when he was diagnosed with Graves' disease and given 6 months to live. His poor health prevented him from being enlisted in World War I. Yet, he lived a good long life. He died in 1983. In 1920, he joined the faculty at the Royal College of Music, where he remained until 1917. Howells was also an organist that served in many big cathedrals in England, including St. John's College, Cambridge, King's College, Gloucester Cathedral, and others. He was well known for many settings of the Anglican liturgy that he composed over a 30-year period. And late in his life, he primarily composed for chorus and organ. I will now play from his set of psalm preludes. He has us reflect on this text from Psalm 34, verse 6, which states, "I called in my affliction, and the Lord heard me and saved me from all my troubles."
Thank you.
My last piece is the third of three liturgical improvisations for organ by George Oldroyd. Mr. Oldroyd was an English organist, composer, and teacher of Anglican church music. He was organist of St. Albans Church, Holborn, from 1919 to 1920, and then of St. Michael's Church in Croydon from 1920 until his death in 1956. He composed numerous settings of the Mass and is best remembered for his Mass of the Quiet Hour. This piece focuses on the words of St. Thomas Aquinas as words of meditation. He writes, "Pour light upon us from above, and fire our hearts with thy strong love. Praise to the Father and the Son, through all ages they run, and to the Holy Paraclete be praise with them and worship meet." Amen.
Thank you.
I again want to thank you so much for joining me today. I want to thank you for listening each week and thank a special listener for a very generous donation to the organ fund that we received earlier this week. I would love for you to consider a monetary gift to the organ fund as well. It is with gifts from people like you who enable us to care for this beautiful instrument. Consider sending us a check payable to St. Paul's Episcopal Church. Please mention the organ fund in the memo of the check. Our address is 401 Duval Street, Key West, Florida, 33040. Thank you so much for your consideration. Have a great, happy, and healthy week. I look forward to seeing you again soon.